Gedenkt die 6 Millionen Juden, was seinen umgekommen al Kiddush Hashem. Gedenkt, was es hat getan mit dein Volk, der deutsche Nazi Amalek. Gedenk Treblinka. Gedenk Auschwitz. Gedenk Buchenwald. Gedenk Majdanek. Gedenk Sobibor. Gedenk die Gaskammern und die Krematorias. Gedenk die 6 Millionen.
Wiffel seinen Scheu nicht ab, soll geheiligt sein die Schau. Mir beweinen sie unrasch, iskadal ve iskadasch. Was verblieben ist uns mehr wie die duftgeglitterte Träer, auf die Quarim, auf dem Asch, iskadal ve iskadasch.
Zum Seucher von die Teuter Kadoshim, mir schweigen, Amenot. In der Stillkeit hör ich räuschen und sieden seier Blut. Ich fühl a Winter kalten Weihen und herr geheime Tritt. Oset, Oset, die Teuter gehen, herein in unser Mit. Sei gehen schon von alle Wegen, wie groß ist seier Zoll. Ich starb in Ort der eine Regge schon 6 Millionen Mal. Und sei? Sei leben euch gleich wieder, euch 6 Millionen Mal. Die Schwesters meine und die Brüder von tiefen Beinen toll. Sei stellen sich weg von vorn, von hinten rechts und links, gefangen seinen mir geworden, von dunklen teuten Ring. Der Ring nimmt enger noch sich schmieden, mir konne nicht daraus. Wer lebt bei Emmes von die Jeden? Und wer ist Schottenbleus? Die Teute seinen Märne Schottens vergast in größer Pein. Sei Ottemen mit unser Ottem, was mir jetzt halt nein. Sei suchen, gucken sichtbar sunder in jeden Pony mein. O, wer hat wer gefunden, was a Wunder? A Keuref, wer a Freund? Der Ruf gefind schon da nicht keinem von allen uns dem Meer. Was soll gedenken zu beweinen, amol sei mit a Träer? Zu bei der Welt ne komme Monnen, verseher heilig Blut. Sei alle, lo mir itz der Monnen in der Gedenkminut.
Mit Lattes auf Leber zerschnitten in Passen, mit Reit uns in Ghetto, es gehen die Gassen. die Häuser begleiten auf ewige Segen und ständig wird jeder Sinne vergehen. With patches on our bodies, striped and parching, they chase us in the ghetto, streets are marching. Our buildings say farewell eternally. Stone faces walk with us at each decree. Und zwischen sie alle, die leeren Meere, a kind auf ihr Ohren, a goldene Lehre. A kind auf ihr Ohren, mein Händel wird zweiten. A rum die Talmidim, begleiten, begleiten. Among them walks a woman, teacher Mira. A child is in her arms, a golden lyre. She clasps another child by his frail hand. The students walk around her trusting band. Me jagt über Hoves on Bräut und on Feier. Das Bräut is a Buch und das Licht is a Bleier. Versammelt die Kinder in Chore Verdire. Es lernen sie weiter, die Lehrerin Mira. They chase us over ruins. No bread, no light. Bread is a book, a pencil shines so bright. She gathers all her children on the floor. Teacher Mira goes on teaching as before.
Wenn Sohn hat die Bluten getrunken, hat Mira, behangen mit Grins die verjossene Tiere. Gekommen der Lehrer Gerstein, mehr wird singen. Der Chor soll rüber die Mäuren klingen.
When sun dried up the blood with branches green, she trimmed the orphan room. So neat and clean. Gerstein, the teacher, came and we shall sing. Over the walls, our children's choir will ring.
Beim Lehnen Peretzes dritte Matone hat untergesegnet das Gebei dieser Konne. Sie haben gehabt und Vertrag ist geblieben. Von 130 bloß mehrere und sieben.
When Peretzes third gift took all the boughs, peril has cut down the rickety house. People were caught by snatches. Save us, heaven. Of 130, Mira remains with seven. Over the walls, our children's choir will ring. Tonight we stand here, zusammen, on the 80th anniversary of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. We remember and honor those who, in the face of boundless, immeasurable suffering, rose up and fought back.
Resistance, kämpfen, the struggle for liberation took place not only by those wielding the garnish in the hand, but through the actions of those like teacher Mira, who Avram Sutzkevel wrote about in his poem. Mira sang, recited Shalom Aleichem's tales aloud, and even when Blois Zibin Kinderlach remained, Mira went on teaching as before.
Why? Why did Mira go on teaching? Why did she continue to gather the children if week by week they withered away? Because she recognized that Hoffnung, hope, the internal refusal to accept that one's life could be completely controlled and determined by another, was something that she and her students could never afford to lose.
A core duty we have as Helfer of our Skifisten is to take the knowledge we have received and transmit it as links in the eternal golden agate. We must balance our optimistic yearning that Schaffen einer schönere und bessere Welt is possible, while opening our eyes and confronting the brutal facts of the current reality, whatever they may be.
Why? Why is it that teacher Mira's story resonates so deeply with us? Our lives are so different. No matter how much we read about the Hulgun, no matter how many times we listen to the accounts of survivors, we will never truly understand her experience. But the sparkle she saw in her children's eyes, this we understand.
Even through great suffering, she couldn't help but care for and nurture the children, her treasures. What teacher Mira saw in these children, we see in our Skifisten. This story shows us that educating and guiding children is always worthwhile. This continuum of receiving and transmitting is what has sustained us as a people. The sparkle in her children's eyes is the very same sparkle we see every week in the eyes of our treasures, our Skifisten, an intrinsic eternal sparkle.
As receivers and transmitters, the memory of the Hulgun and the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising will always live on through us. Our Kahila would not be what it is today if it weren't for the determination of survivors who held on to hope, who rebuilt Jewish institutions here in Melbourne,
who never let go of their tiefe Gläubin in Menschen, their deep belief in humankind. On this 80th anniversary of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising, we stand together to remember the courage of those who resisted and stood up for human dignity, for themselves and others. A principle that has always guided the Bund and Skiff is the idea that we must fight for justice wherever we find ourselves. And so it is a great honour to be joined by Mark Dreyfus, the Attorney General of Australia, whose role centres around protecting the rule of law and advancing justice.
During tonight's commemoration, our Skiffiston will shed light on life in the Warsaw Ghetto by exploring the stories of three families.
Over the walls, our children's choir will ring.
Kovet zeye lichtigen onden.
Could I acknowledge the Bunurong people of the Kulin Nation, the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, and pay my respects to their elders both past and present. I also extend my respect to any Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples present today. I'm honoured to present this address on the 80th anniversary of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. On the 19th of April 1943, German SS and police units entered the Warsaw Ghetto to complete the murderous deportations they had begun the previous year. The final organised acts of resistance to these deportations began on 19th April and lasted 27 days. This event, the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising, was the largest and most significant Jewish uprising of the war and is remembered and commemorated around the world. Here in Melbourne, the uprising has been commemorated by the Jewish Labour Bund each year since 1945. I thank the Bund and its youth arm, SCIF, for the profound honour of inviting me to deliver an address this year. Before the war, Warsaw was home to Europe's largest Jewish community, the second largest Jewish community in the world after New York. 350,000 Jews lived in Warsaw, comprising about 30% of its population. In October 1940, a year after the Germans invaded Poland, German authorities ordered Jewish residents of Warsaw and the surrounding areas to move into a designated area which would be sealed off from the rest of the city. A return to the era of the Jewish ghetto more than a century after the Jewish ghettos had been abolished in Europe. More than 400,000 Jews were forced to live in an area smaller than 4 square kilometres. Conditions were horrendous. A combination of starvation and infectious disease, including typhoid, killed thousands each month. Ed Herman, who was born in 1931, described ghetto conditions like this. During the winter, I was very cold. To keep warm, I stayed in bed, covered by whatever I could find. I was continuously hungry. Because of flour shortages, the meagre bread rations that we received contained sawdust. I was dreaming of the white Kaiser rolls that I had for breakfast before the war in Katowice. In the ghetto, young starving children were begging for food. Dead bodies were just lying in the streets. In July 1942, German SS and police units began the murderous forced deportation of ghetto residents to the Treblinka extermination camp. Between July and September 1942, 265,000 Jews were deported. Thousands more died in the ghetto. The SS and police returned to the ghetto in January 1943. This time they were met with determined resistance, including firearms. They withdrew, but not before another 5,000 Jews were taken. On the 19th of April 1943, the Germans returned to the ghetto with one objective: liquidation. Resistance was better organised this time. The Underground Jewish Fighting Organisation, or ZOB, had warned residents of the raid. ZOB commander Mordechai Anelowich was just 24 years old. He had at his disposal about 700 untrained men, armed with smuggled pistols, homemade grenades, and a handful of rifles. A number of these men were members of the Polish Bund. The defenders of the ghetto faced a German force that numbered 2,000. These SS troops and police were armed with modern weapons and backed by tanks and artillery. In military terms, there was no contest. The heroes of the Warsaw Ghetto of the Uprising didn't have full bellies. They had no training, they had very few weapons, but they had courage. They had pride, they had strength, they knew the meaning of solidarity. With these things, they held their own against the German military machine for almost a month. For 27 days, the heroes of the Warsaw Uprising engaged in guerrilla warfare against a numerically superior foe. For 27 days, they inflicted casualties on the Germans and thwarted forced deportation. Residents of the ghetto defied German orders to assemble. They barricaded themselves in bunkers and they supported their defenders. The Germans responded to the ongoing resistance with murder. Eventually, they burned the ghetto to the ground. So fierce was the fire, the sky above Warsaw turned red. On the 16th of May, 1943, the Germans declared the uprising at an end. Commander of the German operation reported to Berlin, "The former Jewish quarter in Warsaw is no more." 7,000 residents of the ghetto died during the uprising. 42,000 Jews, the remaining Jews of Warsaw, were captured and deported to forced labour camps. Most were murdered before the war ended in 1945. 7,000 Jews were captured at the end of the uprising and sent to Treblinka for extermination. 80 years on, we remember the Warsaw Ghetto uprising for many reasons. We admire the defenders of the ghetto who placed a higher value on the survival of their community, their families, their friends, their fellow Jews, than their own survival. We reflect on the bravery of those who surely understood a small number of untrained, poorly equipped men could not prevail for long against armed and organised German SS troops and police. We look aghast at the inhumanity. We shed tears at the memory of those lost before, during and after the uprising. Hundreds of thousands of Jews in Warsaw, mothers, daughters, fathers, grandfathers, among the 6 million victims of the abomination that was the Holocaust. We remember because we must. We must remember because 6 million died. We must remember because those who survived grow smaller in number each year. We must remember so we can identify and resist anti-Semitism and Holocaust denial. We must remember so never again is not a slogan, but a call to action. Many of us in this room have another reason to remember. My father, George Dreyfus, who is here with us, arrived from Germany and stationed here in July 1939, near his 11th birthday. Less than 2 months later, Germany invaded Poland, triggering World War II. My father travelled with his older brother Richard. A home for Jewish children here in Melbourne cared for them. George and Richard didn't know if they would ever see their parents again. Fortunately, their parents, my grandmother, my grandfather, managed to escape from Germany and arrived in Australia as stateless persons in December that year. My great-grandparents had not been convinced of the need to leave Germany. Three of them perished in the Holocaust. My father, my uncle, my grandparents survived the war because they had the opportunity to emigrate to Australia. In no small way, I owe my life to this country, and I know I am not alone. My parliamentary colleague and former member and leader of SCIF, Josh Burns, is also the grandson of migrants who fled Europe and settled in Melbourne. His grandmother, Gerda Cohen, left Germany in 1938 a week before Kristallnacht. She arrived in Australia in the year before my dad. Yad Vashem has published the oral histories of many survivors of the Holocaust. Tonight, I want to share this reflection by Tzvi Kapolovich. And I quote, "And so, within 7 months, I lost my father, my brother, and my mother. I am the only one who survived. This is what the Germans did to us, and these are things that should never be forgotten. On the other hand, we had our revenge. The survivors were able to raise magnificent families, among them myself. This is the revenge and the consolation. Don't forget and find consolation in your family. I won't forget, and I find consolation in my magnificent family every day. Thank you."
Was darf er mir mitnehmen?
Wo wollen wir schlafen?
Hat nicht kein Meure, wir wollen alt schaffen. Ich darf bringen mein Machse in Gemore Biffel, welch können davnen im Beis Medrash.
Kann ich mitnehmen mein Pilke?
Ja, du kannst mitbringen deine Spielzeit.
I must bring my books and teaching materials. I'll then be able to teach at the Yiddish Tishor School in secret.
The Yiddish textbooks will also be of use to the children.
Tishoshu.
Do I need to bring our bed linen?
Yes.
Can we take our goat?
I don't think we can.
We will leave a lot behind. Oi, I will miss Shedlitz.
Are there places where we will be able to play?
Put everything into the wagon. We'll have to schlep for a few kilometers.
Look, the golden stains are on their way to the ghetto.
Mir verlassen sehr schöne parfeme Tiere.
Der Befehl heißt, dass wir müssen überziehen sich in der Gegend morgen. Leben die Gassen von Mille und Nelevke.
Darf ich verpacken unsere Teller und Marscherin zu kochen essen?
Ja, und Frucht und das übrige Fleisch von Nächten.
These beasts will not debase us. We will continue to live our lives as normal.
Will we be able to go to skiff, to school?
You will absolutely be going to skiff and school every Sunday, despite the Nazis.
Don't worry, children. You will have more kids to play with in the city. You won't be taunted by the anti-Semitic kids. You will be amongst Eigener.
I dread the big city. It's dirty and there are Ganovim.
Firstly, we'll have to find a place to live between Miller and Nalevka streets.
Will we be together with the Goldbergs? I'd love to play with Papa.
Die Deutschen sind ein raffinierter, kultureller Menschen. Es wird sein in Ordnung.
Schnell, nei einen dein Marie Nachher Colonel, allein die zwei goldene Ringe.
We will have to wear a Morgendorfin armband.
Are we only allowed one suitcase each? Give me yours, it's bigger.
Alt geht mir noch am Kegen jener Tag, wie Barsche Beut der Ghetto Mäuer. Die Gassen werden blind bei jedem Rock. Beim Anton Serge der Kleid von Treue. Die rote Wand wird Ansorg von dem Blut, bei Jike, Nalevke und Miller. Dies wird jedes Haus in ein Minut an Ohren an der schwarzen Hülle. Wie Kinder scheiden ab von sich die Frei, verlöschen das Licht von heller Lieder. Und betteln euch bei Mames dem Bescheid, wenn wird man megen weinen wieder.
Thank you.
Ich hab heint übergehört, wenn ich bin gewesen in Jabowski Gasse. Was gefindet sich unser Jungrat? Adam Tschernikow, der Anführer, hat der Mann, als wir werden kennen, arbeiten in die Fabriken.
Wird das sein gut für uns?
Sie haben doch konfisziert unser Haus.
Und unser Geld, unser Vermögen?
Alles haben die Nazis zugenommen.
The escape of 7 leaders of the Judenrat last week, including Shmuel Zigerbund, our Bundesleader, has left a huge vacuum. Adam Tschernikow does his best, but the police are a corrupt lot.
I don't like the notion of the Judenrat. They are puppets of the Nazis.
I am uncertain. We have to have some sort of leadership, or else it will degrade into wild animals.
A policeman spoke to us at school today.
Tate, the Jewish police closed our school today.
They also checked each of us to see if we were wearing our armbands.
Well, we'll have to have classes at home, and you'll go to SCIF meetings. School in SCIF is being clandestinely held in the soup kitchens for children.
Es ist eine Hilfsfondorganisation, was stützt unter die Kirche. Das Spar ein bisschen Brot und Suppe, was man kriegt dort, wird weniger und weniger.
Ich bin nächtig gewesen bei den Rotsteins und ich habe gespielt mit Malken. Bei sie ist es so eng. 10 Menschen in ein Zimmer. Wir haben gemusst spielen in Häuf.
Wir müssen sich wenden zu den Städteorganisationen. Sie wollen uns helfen. Mit Medizin, Essenwaren.
Ich habe gegeben einen Polizist, ein paar Zlotys. Er soll uns sagen von voraus. Erzählen wegen neuen Meldungen von einem Jurenrat.
Bei was? Wie soll Wetter uns helfen?
Efter, weil wir können gefühlen, ein besser Tier. Bekommen wir Essenwaren für die Kinder.
Ich bin geworden ein Mitglied von Oinek Shabbos. Ich helfe sie protokollieren, alles was geschieht in Ghetto. Ich habe gehört, als jetzt seinen 400.000 jeden verspart in anderthalben Quadratkilometer in der Ghetto.
Seinen alle jeden von Falsche?
Nein, sie werden reingeschickt von die Provinz Städtlach und andere Länder. Nächten seinen rein in Ghetto. 15.000 deutsche Jeden.
Talk of setting up resistance groups. I bet that Mitek is smuggling in more than potatoes.
I attended a concert last night with my friend and I heard that succumbed to Kwasen. The conductor is Jakob Gladstein.
Das Jingle vom Ghetto.
Er weiß nicht kein Schreck. Er steht auf Beginen und geht gleich weg. Er klettert
auf Kaiser
von Stoll und von Stein. Es mattert der Hunger, er der Stick das Gewehn.
Der Schäumer beim Teuer, von Stahl ist ein Herz, noch harter von Eisen, noch schwarzer von Schwarz. Das Jingo von Ghetto, er guckt an dem Teut, so bringt der Mann ein Stickele Bräut.
Thank you.
This might be our opportunity to get out of here. It's rumoured that the Germans have set up work camps, so we'll have to get used to some physical work.
Are you sure? How will we survive there? Food is already rationed here.
I would like to get out of here.
Me too. There are people now dying of typhus, beggars are everywhere. Surely it might be better in the east.
I saw them round up Jews today. There were thousands at the station and more with the Nazis called the Umschlagplatz. I smell a rat. I've heard they're setting up resistance groups. I want to join them.
Today, the 22nd of July, 1942, I documented that the roundup actions have begun. Some 3,500 Jews were forcibly taken from their homes. During the month of August, 1942, 66,703 Jews were deported to a place called Treblinka.
I've heard rumours about Treblinka. It is not a work camp. Someone here in the clothing factory recognised a coat that belonged to their cousin. What can this mean?
This is horrible. We need to hide when they do the roundups. I saw thousands of Jews herded into trains in Stubsky Street. Children crying, soldiers with guns, dogs barking. I'm scared.
Adam Chernikov, the leader of the Judenrat, committed suicide. Someone said in the note he left for his wife that he can no longer be complicit with the Nazi orders. I always thought that the Judenrat was too quick to carry out Nazi orders, especially the Jewish police.
I saw the saddest sight today. All the children, dressed in their finest, from the Sliska Street orphanage led by Janusz Korczak and a few nurses, were walking to the Umschlagplatz.
Psst, Mr. Policeman, I have a ration card for the next 2 weeks. I will give it to you if you explain where the best place to hide is, so I can miss the roundups.
What do you have? Ration cards? Your mother's diamond ring would be better.
Papa, you know that some time ago, I joined the Ghetto, the Yiddish Kampf Organisation. Many Zukunftisten have joined.
You convinced me, so today I joined as well. I met Klepfisch, who is in charge of making infantry weapons, and Hochberg, who is impatient to fight. And Topsha Davidovich, her role is liaison officer between the underground battle groups.
Boy, children, this is dangerous work.
The first resistance fight in the January deportations helped some 5,000 assembled Jews escape from the Umschlagplatz. Father, seeing these Nazis so disorientated, encouraged me to join the resistance.
We Jews must resist. I'm proud of you all. Resistance is all that's left for us. You know that over 250,000 of us were deported from July to September 1942. There are only about 75,000 of us left.
Dort, auf jener Seite, ist die Freiheit. Setzt sie von der Weit durch die Drotten. Dort, auf jener Seite, der Freier liegen. Dorten läuft die Zeit, dorten leben Menschen frei. Bruder, nimm mein Hand, Herre Feinen. Bruder, kalt ein Bräut mit die Zähler, nicht gucke hin mehr an die Berg. Ziehen fällt der Grün, dorten, lieber Bruder meiner. Vergess all dem, vergess und kalt ein Bissen. Trink dein Pein und fress. Und hast du Kischen? Leg dein schweren Kopf dein Leben. Hollen dir in Schlaf. Dort tu schmieden dir dein Freiheit.
My father and my mother and father decided to take a chance with resettlement in the East. I saw them board the train from my hiding place. Now I know that this was a huge mistake. The resistance people have let us know that the Nazis are planning a final deportation action and that we must all find bunkers to hide in.
Jeder ruft mir Jamele. Ach, wie ist mir schwer. Chob gehat a mamele, chob zi shoy nishmea. Chob gehat a tatele, hot a mich gehid. It bin ich a shmatele, weil ich bin a yid. Chob gehat a shvesterl, is zi mea nish da. Ach, wo bist du, Esterl, in der schwere Tscha? Gets bei a boimele, gets bei a ploit. Lickt mein Bruder Schleumele, von a deitsch getoit. Chob gehat a heimele, it's is mir schlecht. Ich bin wie a Behemele, was der Talien schert. Gott, du guckst von Himmele, auf dein Erde ab. Guck zu wie dein Blimele, reißt der Gaslen ab.
Come, children, we will hide in this bunker. The resistance has warned us that the Nazis will come into the ghetto and start the deportations again. We'll be safe here for a while.
How will we live there? It's dark, it stinks. We only have our rations for 2 days.
Don't worry, I will scavenge around at night when it is safe for food.
We will have to share this bunker with other families. It will be crowded. Everyone is thinking of hiding to avoid the roundups.
The Nazis are mobilizing outside the ghetto. It is rumored to be a final push to resettle us all.
You heard what Mark Edelman said. In the last month, some weapons were smuggled into the ghetto. They will be distributed to the commanders, who will join Edelman at Zamenhof Street later tonight.
I guess it'll be a quick sitter tonight.
A Kampf für unsere Freiheit.
O 12.05 do 2.15 już Niemcy obstawili mury getta. Niemcy, granatowa policja, szaulisi, Estończycy. Co 25 metrów dookoła muru byli ludzie, stali z karabinami, wszyscy wycelowanymi w stronę getta. Niemcy przez te otwory, które były, wchodzili powoli po 2-3 osoby. Trwało to dosyć długo. No i rano zebrała się wielka kolumna niemiecka, ustawiona, plutony, bataliony i tak dalej. Przyjechały czołgi i gdzieś o 7 rano z ulicy Miłej na Zamenhofa zaczęła wchodzić do getta. Tam były zabarykadowane nasze 4 grupy. Tam weszli, zostali niespodziewanie obrzuceni granatami. Czołgi obrzucone butelkami zapalającymi. Odbyła się bitwa jak gdyby, tylko że nie wiedzieli Niemcy, gdzie jest wróg. I się rozpieszli. A myśmy byli na piętrze zamaskowani. I to jak gdyby było nasze pierwsze zwycięstwo. Musieli się wycofać. I wycofali się na parę godzin z getta. Dopiero później, około godziny 10, też wiem z tego, co było później, objął dowództwo nad wojskami niemieckimi generał Strop. I jeszcze raz, ale teraz już inaczej, zaczął wchodzić do getta. To już w szyku bojowym, skokami pod murem, kryli się. Jeszcze utrzymywaliśmy te pozycje, które mieliśmy rano. Także przedarli się przez jedną ulicę, drugą ulicę i na trzeciej ulicy, gdy im się zdawało, że są już pewni, tam był znowu nowy, znaleźli nowy opór. Była barykada zrobiona z mebli, z beczek, z szyn żelaznych. I na tej barykadzie właściwie skończył się ten dzień. Skończył się ten dzień walki, jak gdyby nasz zwycięski dzień. Niemcy niczego nie zdobyli, nikogo nie wywieźli, nikogo nie wyprowadzili i nie zdobyli terenu.